was another successful day here on day four for the quarterfinals, with plenty of tennis for fans to watch. Now, first up, it was a battle of the qualifiers with Tamira Paschek versus Kirsten Flipkins.
Neither player is playing extremely well out there, in my opinion. Paschek, as you say, just maintaining her mental equilibrium better than her Belgian opponent.
Yeah, it hasn't been anything spectacular, has it, from either?
Paschek will be pleased as well. She'll know that she hasn't played as well as she can, but she's still a set up, so it's irrelevant whether she played a great set or an OK set if she's still got one on the board beside her name. Look at the highlights of the second set. Impressively, Kirsten Flipkins just began to play her way back into the match. Sensed that Tamira Paschek, while coming up with some superb passing shots, started to tire a little bit. Flipkins started to get a glimpse of how she might play her way back into the set and into the match. Her ability to mix the ball up, bring her opponent to the net, come to the net herself, place her serves was impressive. And ultimately the difference in the two players as the tiebreaker finished. Kirsten Flipkins forcing this match into a third and deciding set. And as we see highlights of the third set, what the pictures don't convey all the time is the tension out there. You could have heard a pin drop at times as the crowd ebbed and swayed with these players. Both players showing us a fine array of their repertoire. Check the winner will be a better player for having won this match, because she was forced to put her character on the line and to show the belief that so many people have had in her this week and prove to herself that she can win the points and the matches that matter.
Five love up, she was up in that third set too.
As we look at the match statistics, a lot of unforced errors from Kirsten Flipkins.
Plenty more quarterfinals action on centre court, with the consistent baseliner Nao Hibino taking on a familiar face to the tournament, Julia Gerges.
Well, as we see the highlights of the first set, for me it was Hibino's equilibrium. Pretty unfazed by wonderful winners from Gerges, but also a lot of unforced errors. Hibino made a few errors from the back of the court herself, and we'll know if she can tidy up that area of her game in the second set. She has every chance of taking out the victory. And significantly, Gerges a little frustrated with the umpire, remonstrating with him and herself, which always suggests she is not totally comfortable and focused on the point ahead of her. Let's have a look at the highlights of the second set. It was all Gerges, really. Way fewer unforced errors in the second set. Significantly, she got out to a 1-0 lead in the second set, broke Hibino's serve. That seemed to give her an element of confidence which took her through the rest of the set. And as a bonus, she broke young Japanese serve again.
Gerges into the semi-finals.
Well, if we look at the highlights of the third set, Gerges was increasingly impressive with a strong serve. That set up so many opportunities to hit winners from the baseline. She had one or two forays into the net and was confident with her volley. She's an accomplished doubles player. feel as though Beno played badly. She just didn't have an answer when push came to shove, and Julia Gurgis hit forehands like that all over the court. Look at the match statistics. Gurgis still higher in the unforced error count, but look at that phenomenal statistic, 26 forehand winners. And obviously got a high percentage of first serves in the court and won many of those first serve points as well.
Fans are excited to see this matchup, and it was Sloane Stephens from the US against the crowd favourite, Naomi Brody.
And here are the numbers, in fact, the highlights.
Whenever there was a rally, Sloane Stephens tried to play very aggressive, but the most problem she's had was just returning Naomi Brody's serve. That's where most of the unforced errors came. Both players showed some amazing fighting spirit, no emotions actually out there today. But she's won the more important points, a little bit unlucky maybe Naomi Brody at the end when she had that match point or set point. As we have a look at the second set highlights, it was pretty even at the beginning. Once again, I thought that Brody was going to be gone after losing that first set, but she hung in there. Yeah. Sloane Stephens tried to be a little bit more aggressive, stepping into the court, trying to get to those sidelines. And when she did, she usually made the point. It was not an easy thing to have that rhythm against Naomi Brody, who served exceptionally well, once again putting so much pressure on the opponent. And here are the match statistics. The big difference is obviously the unforced errors, 52 for Naomi Brody compared to 21 for Sloane Stephens. Brody will always have more unforced errors, I think, because she's just an aggressive player. She also has more winners than Sloane Stephens, but Sloane Stephens overall had the better end and was the more consistent player out there.